So we left things off by wanting now to show that we have this equivalence class on G containing A. So there's some element A in the set that makes up the group, and we define it by this equivalence relation, such that if I have A and B elements of my set G, that I have A inverse composed with A with B, that A inverse composed with B, that will be an element of H. And I want to show that this set is the same as this set with A, this composition with H, such that H is an element of my subgroup, that these two are equivalent. And I said if I want to show that two sets are equivalent, I've got to show that one is a this is a subset of that, and that is a subset of that. So in our proof, first let's show that this is indeed a subset of A composed with H, such that H is an element of my subgroup. Let's show that that is so. Now, first of all, let's just choose an element in this equivalence class, and we'll just say let X be an element of this equivalence class, this equivalence set. And if that is so, it does mean that X inverse composed with A must be an element of this. And let's say then it's an element of this. And I'm just going to say that by the symmetric property, because we've shown that it is an equivalence class, I also have to have A inverse X being an element of that. And I've defined it such that, remember that this relation at the moment I'm dealing with that left relation is an such that if I created two of these, it must be an element of H. It must be an element of H. Let's choose an arbitrary element in H. So that is going to, let's say, equal H, an element of H. Quite legitimate to do, because that is how I defined my equivalence relation. And because H is a group, A inverse is in that group, that means its inverse, which is this A, must also be in that group. So I would have A inverse AX equals A, should have put that one there. So put if that's an element, this must be an element. Left multiplied or addition, whatever this binary operation is on that side, this gives me this by the associative law, this gives me the identity element. So I'm showing X is equal to A H, which is an element of H, and that will only happen if X is then an element of this, if X is in there. So I've just shown now that if X is in this equivalence class, it is a subset of that. X is a subset then of this side. In other words, X must be in this, when it's in there, it must be a subset of there. So I've shown it in this direction. So that's quite easy to do. Let's just look at this side, where I have my set such that H is an element of H. I must now show that this is a subset of the equivalence class on that. Once again, I'm going to choose an X. Let's X be an element of this set, AH, such as H is an element of H. And if it is an element of that, I can just say, choose it to be one of those. If I multiply on the left, or binary operation on the left with X, that is going to equal H, which is an element of H. If I've shown it in this way, it means it's an equivalence relation. That is how I defined my equivalence relation. In other words, what I've shown here is this is the same as this equivalence relation that we had. And if that is so, it means it must be a subset, it must be inside of A as well. So I've shown this way around as well, that this must be a subset of that. And if I've shown both of these, I have shown both of those being a subset, it means these two are equal to each other. And remember, this is the left. I've just shown the left coset here, and I must also again, you can look at that yourself. If you turn all of these around, show that the right coset exists as well. So this would be the left coset, on H, and this would be the right coset. So not a difficult proof to show that one is indeed a subset of another. And this turns out also to be very important as we will move eventually to Lagrange's theorem.